Hello, everyone. How are you all today? Thank you all for being here. This is Dr. Lynn Daniel coming to you today to talk about why pursue a doctorate late in life, like I did. All right. So I have 5 points in my notes here. So if you see me looking down, I'm looking at my notes. But I pursued my doctorate. I was 51 years old when I applied and when I was accepted to the program. I turned 52, and every year I turned a year older. I was in a 5-year program at Concordia University, Chicago, in their leadership language literacy, reading language literacy program. And I enjoyed the process. All right. So why should you? You're considering, you want to get a doctorate, or at least you're interested. Why should you? And especially if you are getting up in years like I am. So first, you must have a passion for whatever it is you will be studying. You have to have a passion for that, because the coursework that you take first as a doctorate student is mandatory, compulsory. And I'm getting an alert on my phone. And it may be boring, tedious. Right? It's setting the tone for the massive amount of reading that you're going to be doing and thinking about the reading, that critical thinking, writing. So get the coursework done and be passionate about your interests, what you plan to study during your candidacy. Okay, so have a passion. The second point is, you're doing it for professional development, right? You're wanting either professional recognition, some kind of career advancement, an opportunity to serve your professional community, however that looks. So professional development, professional service is another good reason to pursue a doctorate late in life. Personal development is another good reason, because you are personally achieving goals that you set for yourself, and you are like making yourself stronger, wiser, tougher, you know, more well-rounded, and you're in improving your expertise about yourself and your ability to handle the critical components of the doctorate and manage your life and budget your resources, because your executive functioning skills must be right on point, or you're going to have to get them on point, because the doctorate requires so much. So it's going to help you. It's going to, if you're not already there, it's going to force you and move you into a lot of planning of everything of your time, including family time and self-wellness time and self-pampering time and meals prep and fitness and all of that. So for personal development, the doctorate will help you achieve that. The fourth reason is for service. So the doctorate is an opportunity for you to hone your craft, find your voice, speak what it is that you're passionate about, and researching and speak it to serve your community. So this information that you're putting together in your dissertation and in any manuscripts that you write is to serve the community that you're part of, your professional community, to inform them of your expertise and to help to make the community better. So service. And then collaboration. So the doctorate provides opportunities for you to collaborate in a lot of ways, like study groups, especially when you're in just the coursework phase, and writing groups. So in some of the doctoral groups that I am a member of, there are writing sessions that are held and where students, candidates get together, and they're working on their own individual dissertation or manuscript, but they are in there together. Many of these take place online, so on Zoom or other platforms. And it's the research even shows that that is beneficial because the camaraderie or, you know, the accountability is there, and you're meeting, you're physically present online, and you're working. So writing groups, even writing collaboratively on manuscripts to publish. So authoring and co-authoring publications is another reason to collaborate and to pursue your doctorate. It's giving you an opportunity to share your voice, to find your voice on your expertise, on your topic of expertise, and to share your expertise. All right. So thank you all for viewing the video. Check out my other videos on the dissertation process. And then I have lots of videos about other things here on this channel. So just find what you like. I have home videos. My hobby is home decor. I have videos on hair care. And so find what you like and stick around. All right. Be sure to thumbs up if you found benefit in this video and subscribe. Be blessed. Bye.